Welcome to story time with a difference today. I'm going to light a fire, seeing as though it's forest schools. I've been wanting to do this with you at school for a very long time, so I thought I'd start now. Alfie has had to stay inside, sadly, because I thought he might be a bit too excited about the fire. So I'm going to give you a little bit of a hack. You've got a fire pit like I have at my house. Tumble dry fluff is very, very good for starting. Start with a bit of that. Now our fence blew down and it was very, very windy a few weeks ago. Mr. Kirkwood chopped it all up so we can use it in the fire. So I'm going to use some of the smaller pieces just to start the fire off. Get the fluff near the top. Perfect. And now I'm going to use this flint. You could use whatever you want, really. You could use a match or anything else. You can only have a fire with a grown-up, so please don't do this by yourself. And only if your grown-up is happy. If not, you can just share my fire. It takes a while to get started. There we go. And as the tumble dryer fluff starts to burn, we'll pop a little bit of wood on. So that it catches. Go on it. That also works a treat. Put too much wood on to start with, otherwise your fire will go out. Just little bits. It's a bit smoking. Going. Oops. Okay. I've got some bigger pieces of wood over here. I actually bought these from the garage. And these are really good slow burning pieces of wood. So once they catch fire, then the fire will be really, really, really strong. Because fires sometimes do go out, even if you don't want them to. Story time today. He's helping me with the camera.
Afternoon, children.
He's not very busy at the moment, so he was a bit bored. So I said he could help me. Now, only let the grown-ups put the wood on the fire. You can sit by and watch. See if your grown-ups are good at fire lighting. Well, next week, I'm going to light a fire like this. I'm going to show you how to cook something on it, if you want to have a go. Again, only with a grown-up, only if they feel happy. If not, you can just watch me. That's fine. Just going to put a little bit more on there, it's getting nice and strong. Can you see the flames are higher, but not too high. Not too high. I'm just going to move around a little tiny bit. Close to the fire now, it's really, really going strong. I'm going to kneel on one knee like this so that I can move quickly if I need to. I'm very good at the lighting fire, so I think I'm going to be okay. A couple more pieces of wood now. Oops. Garage for a very long time. So we've been working with sticks today in forest school. I thought I'd just put a stick on the fire while I read today's story. Stanley's stick. We often read this one at forest schools. Really nice one. And a little boy in my my class has got a brother called Stanley, and I know that you'll be watching. Stanley stands on Stockport Station with his stick. Stanley always carries his stick with him. There he is, can you see? Stanley's stick was once part of something tall and grand, and it will never return. But it can still be a stick, as best as it can be. Stanley has a lot of stick activity, like pretending the stick is a whistle, or a banana. It is quite straight. You don't have to be great to be great. Look, it's a dinosaur that isn't extinct. It's a Stegosaurus. Stanley has tried out some names for his stick, like Starry and Moon, but these names were all the wrong shape. For a while, he liked Sturry, but that's better for a spoon. Stanley's stick is good for writing in the sand, in languages that only Stanley can understand. And four times now, he has used his stick to pick up slugs from pathway, platform and pavement, thus saving them from a fate worse than feet. Stanley's friend Bertie has some string, and sometimes they tie the string to the stick's end and go pretend fishing. Now, because the fish are pretend, no fish get hurt, says Bertie. So, here is Stanley standing at the station, taking his stick for a short stay, at the side of the sea with his mum and dad. The train pulls in. Down at the sea, Stanley goes to the side of the tide. His folks take stock of Stanley standing in the sand, stick in hand. What's he doing? Maybe the boy thinks it's time for the stick to be taken for somebody else to enjoy. Stanley hurls his stick into the wide tide. Gosh, what a tiny splosh for something that has been so big in Stanley's days. The sea picks up the stick and tucks it into itself. Stanley is stickless. The next morning, back at their spot on the beach, the tide is out. Stanley treads towards the spreading sea. Boats ride sea back out on the distance. Stanley decides to look for interesting sticks, for other sticks, which have been carried twiggyback upon the turning tide. Soon he stumbles upon a stick alone upon the shore. It is quite different from the stick he had before. It is wonky. Oh! This stick is an unusual saxophone. Stanley thinks of home and begins to blurt a tune for Bertie. Now Stanley stares at the sea through his stick. It is wonky, and this stick Stanley knows the name of. It's called Fantastic, and that's the end. See if you can find an interesting stick when you're out and about on your little walks, and maybe you could pretend something exciting. Fire is going out now. Just the last few flames, and I'll put some water on it. Make sure it's really properly out. And I'm going to go and get some tea. See you tomorrow.